everyone here at Jada in Stitches.
Hey everybody, welcome to the Jada in Stitches show. In keeping with all of the requests we get for Granny Square projects, I thought we'd do one that was sort of holiday related, and I'd show you how to make a traditional Granny Square Christmas stocking. But I like the ones with the rounded toe, as opposed to that sort of squarish effect you can get using Granny Squares. So today, I'm going to show you how to make, well, this. This is a traditional Granny Square Christmas stocking with a rounded toe. So, what do you need to make one of these? Just so happens, I have a list of stuff you need right here. Granny squares. This is the basis of the stocking. You're going to need 8 of them. 8 granny squares. How big do you make your granny squares? Well, that's entirely up to you. But if you want an average size Christmas stocking, I recommend this size. This is a 3 round granny square made with a size 4 worsted weight yarn. This is Christmas yarn, and I grabbed a couple 100-gram balls of the stuff. So it's a 4-ply, size 4, worsted weight. This case, this is acrylic, but you can use any yarn you want. Just make sure that if you're mixing up your colors, you use all the same type. And I used a slightly larger hook than I normally do. This is an eye, or a 5.5-millimeter hook. So 5.5 millimeter hook, worsted weight yarn in your favorite colors, a 3 round granny square. So 3 rounds, round 1, round 2, round 3, or row 1, row 2, row 3. If you need help with the granny square pattern, then you can check out my tutorial, and I will put a link up here, or you can also check out the description box down below, and you can visit that tutorial for more help on the granny squares. So once again, 3 rows in a granny square, with a 5.5 millimeter hook, and you'll be good. Then, after you've made 8 of those, you're going to want to attach them in sets of 4. 4 in an L, and 4 in a J. One going this way, one going that way. And if it kind of confuses you, you can literally make them both this way and just put them one reverse one. So it doesn't really matter, unless you're particular about right and wrong sides in your granny squares. But most granny squares kind of flip back and forth as you work, so there really isn't too much of a right or wrong side. So you need to attach them 4, like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. If you have trouble attaching your granny squares, and you can do them by sewing them together like I have here, or like single crocheting them together, like I've done here on this one. It's entirely up to you. However you want to attach your granny squares is your choice, and if you need help attaching your granny squares, I have a tutorial for that too. You can check it out right here, or it's in the description box down below. So once again, granny square tutorial and the how to attach your granny squares, both links in the description box down below. So you want to attach them in sets of 4. Then we're going to go ahead and put a border on them. And this is where I'm going to catch you up with today's tutorial. Remember, in addition to your crochet hooks, you always need a good pair of scissors and a yarn needle. This is to weave in all your ends. So make sure after you've made all of your granny squares, you weave in all of your short ends and get them out of your way. Once you've got your granny squares all either sewn together or slip stitched together or single crocheted together, whatever you decided on, we're ready to put on our borders. The border is done around each side. So for example, I've got an L side and a J side, and I'm going to put a border around each side first before I attach them. This is to give it a little more width. It's also to give it sort of some unification in color. You don't have to change your color like I've done. I've done this because, well, I like red and white and green, but I also wanted to be able to demonstrate where all of the different differences, I should say all the different sections are. So in between the squares, you can see where I've joined them. You can also see where the borders begin and end. And so you can do them all one color or multiple colors, whatever you like. Here's how we start the border. Grab your border color and your crochet hook. You're going to want to make a slip knot to start.
And single crocheting is what we're going to be doing here. If you've done other borders with me before around granny squares or other granny square projects, you know that I like to start with a single crochet border because it's a nice small unifier. So I'm going to start in this top corner stitch. So you see how I've made my granny squares with two corner chains. I'm going to start on the second chain, so sort of the chain that's on the downside of my granny square. And I'm going to try and get it through the whole chain, and if I can't do that, I'll just grab that first loop. And I'm going to join with a single crochet. I like joining with single crochets if I'm single crocheting, because it's just sort of quicker. There we go. Now, all I want to do is single crochet into each stitch, so the top of each of my double crochets, and into each space all the way down the length of my first side. So I'm going to just do the top of each double crochet. So I'm single crocheting and I'm just doing it into the top of each of the previous stitches. And when I get to a space, if you're in a hurry, you can use the whole space. But if you want to try and grab a piece of that chain, because you want to be sort of, let me just get that out of the way. You see what I've done? I've put my hook through the chain, so there's a little bottom piece running underneath it. This is if you are a little bit particular and you want all of your stitches to kind of match. And I'll show you what that looks like. When you use the actual chain in the space instead of the whole space, you can see that you've still got a little bit of the green or a little bit of the fabric running underneath that stitch. It also allows all of your single crochet to sit in alignment. If you use the whole space, and again, that's fine, there's no rules here, but if you use the whole space, those single crochets are going to sit just a little bit below the ones on either side of it. So it's entirely up to you. You don't have to do it if you like. You can if you want. If you're particular, like me, then you can just use the chain as opposed to the whole space. But that's all you're going to do. You're just going to single crochet down the side and make sure you get one in each space or those chains. Now, when you come to a joining area, this is always sort of a funny spot. When you're putting together an afghan, I like to try and even use the stitch together space or the single crocheted together space because I like to have more give on a blanket. But when you're making something small like this little stocking project, I like to put a single crochet in the space or the stitch just before the join. So there's my first one. Skip the join and move right into the space or the stitch immediately next to it. That's because we're making a firmer little project. So we don't want a granny square Christmas stocking to have too much give, because you want it to be able to withstand the weight of the stuff you're going to put in it. So when you single crochet down the side of your sewn together or single crochet together squares, just skip that join space and single crochet on either side of it, and then continue. And that will just make it a slightly stronger project. Depending on which side you are adding your border to first, eventually you're going to come to the inside corner. The inside corner is a bit tricky, and you eventually want it to look like this. You don't want to lose that corner or that nice little angle. It doesn't matter if it's a bit softened, but you don't want it to disappear. So there's a little trick. We're going to single crochet three together across this corner. So we're going to pick up a stitch in that first space or stitch on the immediate side of our first set of joined blocks. So there's one. Skip over, grab the next space or stitch between the next two, and if you have to use your hook, that's what it's there for. There we go. Pick up a loop. Skip over that join and into the next space or stitch, whichever you're using, pick up a loop. So you've got four loops on your hook now, wrap, and go through all of them. And we are single crocheting those three different spaces or stitches together. And that is going to create a nice, neat corner. It's going to keep that shape going for you. And once you've done that, you can just continue single crocheting in the top of each stitch and space all the way along to our next corner. Once you get up to your toe section, and it doesn't matter what side you're doing this on, you have to treat both of these corners in your toe section the same way. You want a you want sort of this nice rounded look, ultimately. So we're going to treat the little corners a bit differently than we might treat a corner if we were putting on a single crocheted border on a regular granny square. You're going to approach your corner, put your last single crochet in the top of your last stitch. Once you get to the corner, put your hook through the whole thing, single crochet, and then keep going. You can continue single crocheting into each stitch across the top of your toe section, or I should say the toe part of your toe section. You can continue treating each of your spaces or those stitches the way you were for the rest of your booty. So for example, if you're using the stitch, use the stitch. If you're just single crocheting into the space, use the space. The only difference here is when you get to the corners for your toe, you're just single crocheting into the corner once. Here I am at the other corner. So I'm still in the toe section. I did a single crochet into that corner space, and I'm going to treat the other corner space the same way. I'm going to work the whole space, and I'm only going to put in a single crochet. So one single crochet. Why am I doing that? Well, let me just put in a few extras here. And you can see it's already starting to round it. You see how by taking out the chains, it's already rounded the corners. So those nice sharp corners that I had on my original granny square have completely dulled because instead of putting in a typical corner with chains, I only put a single crochet into that corner space, and that has rounded out my toe. And this foundation border row is where we start to shape the granny square Christmas stocking so that it looks more like a stocking and less like a bunch of squares all slapped together. So once you've put a single crochet, so one single crochet into each of those corner spaces, you can just continue along and you can do the same thing. You can do a single crochet or one single crochet into this corner space, or you can treat it like you would a regular corner, depending on if you want a nice sharp corner in your heel or if you want a rounded corner in your heel. I'm going to leave that up to you. Just so you know, I treated my corners, my corner heel, with a little bit of a rounding. So I did the same thing I did in this corner. I only single crocheted into it once because I wanted a little bit of a roundness happening, and that's what I did. So I'm going to do the same thing just so both my sides match, but it's entirely up to you. If you like a nice sharp heel, go ahead and put in a regular corner. If you want a nice rounded heel, like a rounded toe, then work one single crochet into that corner space. And once you've done all that, I'll see you back up at the top. Okay, I have gone all the way around the first side of my stocking, my big Christmas booty. And I'm up to the top, and I need to do the corners and the last little bit of the row. So I like my corners up at the top to look like regular corners. So this is what I'm doing up here. I'm identifying my first corner chain. And again, if you're working into the corners, you can just do this right through the whole space. So, but I'm going to do the chain. I'm single crocheting into that first chain, or you can put it into the whole space. Again, up to you. Chaining two, like a regular old corner, and working another single crochet into that chain. So I'm trying to just keep my consistency going here. Oh, this is frustrating. Okay, you know what? I'm just going to use the first loop, because you can do that too. There. Now I'm going to work the rest of the stitches across the top of my last square. Okay, I'm almost back to the beginning. I'm going to work the same kind of corner I did over here. So I'm going to pick up that chain or work through this whole space, work a single crochet, chain two, And because I already worked a single crochet in that join, when I first joined, in that corner stitch, I'm just going to join with a slip stitch. So again, if you're working through the whole space, then these top space corners, or the top corner spaces, can be single crochet, chain, single crochet. And if you're using the stitch, so the actual chain from the previous row, same thing. Work a single crochet into that first chain, chain two, and work a single crochet into the second chain. So it's the same thing, it's just that one identifies, sort of, one keeps that space sort of open, and the other way, as you can see, leaves a bit of the green showing underneath. So I kind of like that, and I'm going to do that for both sides. All right, that's the foundation border row done. Now we have one more row to do, because both stocking sides have two rows. So as you can see, this is what it looks like with the first border row done, and this is what it's going to look like with your second border row done, and this is where we really shape up that toe. So here we go. After you've joined with a slip stitch to complete your first border row, you're going to chain one, and you're going to single crochet into that same stitch, so directly below where you just chained, single crochet. Now this is easy. Border rows after the first sort of foundation border row are so much easier because all of your stitches are laid out for you, nice and simple. So you're just going to single crochet in each stitch all the way down, and the first oddball area is going to be that inside corner, and once we get there, I'll show you how to do that. All right, I've zipped all the way down to the first inside corner, or I should say the only inside corner. I worked a single crochet into that stitch just before that one that where we single crocheted three together. So if you can sort of see that, I worked the one before it. Here's the single crochet three together from the previous row, and then there's the regular single crochet right after it. Instead of doing three together here, because this is sort of my last, almost my last border row, I'm just going to single crochet two together. It will continue to keep that corner going, and so just single crochet two together. So you pick up a loop in each stitch and then single crochet them both together. And that, as you can see, will just keep my little corner going nice and neatly. And that's what it looks like on the other side. So you single crochet three together on the first row and just single crochet two together on the second row. And that keeps your corner kind of looking like a corner, but it also kind of rounds it out a little bit because you don't want your stocking to look harshly cornered. And that's it for the inside corner. Then the next tricky bit is the toe, and then it's just straight sailing all the way back up to the beginning of our second row. And let's get to the toe, and I'll show you what to do next. I've just come up to the corner of my toe, and now we're going to start varying our stitch size so that we get this nice rounded toe effect happening here. This is the pattern I'm going to work for that. I've worked my last single crochet in just before that single crochet that sits in the corner stitch from the previous row. So there's my two corner stitches. And remember, I only worked a single crochet into this sort of the space instead of doing a corner because I want that rounded effect to start. So I'm going to work the following. I'm going to single crochet into the next stitch, half double crochet into the next two stitches, I'm going to double crochet into the next six stitches, So just to recap, I single crocheted, half double crocheted twice, double crocheted six times. Now I'm going to half double crochet into the next two, and back to single crochet for the rest of my border edge. I'm not doing anything special in the corners because I want that nice little rounded effect to continue. And from here on out, it's just regular single crochet again. So there you go. There, get my ball out of the way, is that nice rounded toe effect. And we've got that by changing up the stitch height. So we started with a single crochet, half double crocheted twice, double crocheted six times, back to half double crochet, and then single crochet to continue with the rest of our border row. So there you go. Nice little rounded toe, just by varying up our stitch height. Okie dokie, here I am at the corner of the heel. So this is the heel corner. And remember, we just single crocheted right around that corner edge. So we worked a single crochet into each of those two chains that were part of the initial corner of our granny square. And just to keep that nice rounded corner look going, I'm going to single crochet right around. So now if you get around your corner and you feel like it's gonna bunch up on you, you can just put an extra one. So one extra single crochet in one of those two stitches, and that will round your corner for you. That's if you feel you need it. If you just want to work one single crochet into each stitch all the way around and you feel like you still get this nice rounded effect going, you can do that too. But that's a nice little trick. So for example, if you're trying to get a nice rounded corner going and you feel like it's starting to curve on you, or it wants to bend because there's not enough slack, just put in an extra little stitch. You can barely see what I've done. I've worked two single crochet into one of those corner stitches. You can barely tell, and it gives you that nice rounded corner. So that's just a little trick for rounding the corner of your heel. And that's that. Now we just single crochet right back up to the top, join our row with a slip stitch, and we can join our two sides together. I'm just coming up to the top of my stocking here, and remember those corners we worked in the previous row? So I actually went a single crochet into the corner stitch, or if you're just using the space, I chained two. I made an actual corner because I kind of liked that sharp corner edge up there. I'm just going to round it out a little bit now. So I'm going to single crochet into that chain space I made and into each of the single crochets. So I'm not creating a chain two corner, I'm just rounding it out a little. But I don't need a sharp corner there. This is my last border row. And if you can see, it still looks a little bit like a corner, but it's a little more on the rounded side. It has kind of a softer edge. That's sort of the trick with this granny square Christmas stocking. I don't want sharp edges. I want it to look less square and more like a sock. And that is it. That is the second and final border row. I'm just going to treat my last corner exactly like the one I just did. Oops, trying to single crochet into the same one twice here. I'm going to single crochet into that corner stitch. So into that corner space, I should say. I'm just going to single crochet right into it, and then I'm going to join with a slip stitch to the top of that single crochet that I sort of started the row with. And that completes my border. You see how that kind of closes in the spaces, rounds out the corner a little bit, but not too much, but it's not a harsh corner. And that's that. That is the top. And now I've got two sides that are exactly the same. I'm just going to snip my yarn and fasten off. You don't need to keep the yarn, so you don't need a tail. So once you've snipped your yarn, just pull your tail through that loop on your hook, give it a nice tight tug, and then grab your yarn needle and weave in your ends. So you want to weave this end in back and forth a couple times. And once you've done that, we'll move on to connecting them so that we've got one complete Christmas stocking. This is my completed Christmas stocking. I single crocheted them both together. So both sides are single crocheted together. And you can sew yours together, so once you pair up your two edges, you can whip stitch them together, you can slip stitch them together, but I'm going to single crochet them together. It's just going to make it a little bit wider, and it's going to give me an opportunity to just round out those edges a little bit more. So that's what I'm going to do with this one. You want to grab your yarn and create a slip knot. And put it on your hook. Make sure it's nice and loose and doesn't, well, not too loose, but that your hook moves around comfortably. And now we're going to put both our sides together. Make sure you've got the sides you like best facing outwards. And we're going to start in the same place that we did for our borders. So in this top corner. And you're just going to slip your hook in at the corner. And at the corresponding spot on the other side. So this is kind of important. You want to make sure that your stocking sides align and that you've connected through the same kind of pair of stitches from both sides. And then I'm going to join with a single crochet. I'm single crocheting again, so I'm going to join with a single crochet. There. Now, all you need to do is pick up both sides. So I'm going to show this to you nice and close. There's the single crochet that's next in line on side one, and the single crochet that's next in line on side two. So I'm going to pick up a pair of single crochets each time I go to make a stitch. So there's the first side and the second side. There we go. And I'm going to single crochet through them both together. And that is going to be what connects my two sides together. So you're going to get this nice, slightly thicker looking border, and it's going to connect both sides together. So if you're zipping along down the side here and you get to the inside corner or maybe the toe and you find that you're one stitch out, let's say you're just off by one or two, don't worry about it, just cheat them together. This is not a fine science, and it doesn't have to be perfect. So if you're sewing them together, it's a little easier sometimes to cheat stitches together if you're sewing, because it's one strand and you can kind of stick that needle in anywhere you want. But if you're single crocheting them together, try to use each set of stitches as you go down, but if you find when you get to the corners that you're one in or one out, just cheat. So skip a stitch on one side or single crochet it together with another one. Just do whatever you have to make sure that both your sides continue to sit somewhat evenly. You may not have the exact same number of stitches in each final border row for both sides. Sometimes it just works out that way. I don't know why, but you know, when you're zipping along and you're in a hurry or you kind of get carried away in the moment, sometimes you end up adding or dropping a stitch. It's very difficult to make two things exactly identical. I struggle with that myself, making booties or making mittens. So don't feel that if both of your sides aren't completely perfectly identical that you've done something wrong, because chances are you haven't. Things are unique. So even when we try to make two things completely identical, there's still going to be some uniqueness to each side. So don't fret. Just steadily work down both sides together. And when we get to this funny little corner thing, I'll show you a nifty little trick. And it'll keep that nice rounded edge look going. All right, here we are at that inside corner again. We're going to repeat what we did in the final border row for each side of the stocking. So you're going to pick up the next set of stitches, pick up a loop in them, and then do the same thing for the next set of stitches. Pick up a loop and single crochet them together. So you're single crocheting two together across both sides. And that's just going to keep that little inside corner going nice and smooth. I'll get a couple more stitches down and I'll back up and show you what that looks like. So there. There's the inside corner. We single crocheted two together across that corner. Remember to make sure you go through both sides because you want to make sure that you're sort of stitching the whole thing together. but it continues that nice rounded edge and it doesn't look awkward or crumpy. And then we're going to move on to the toe. Okay, the toe section. We want to keep that nice, smooth, sort of rounded border going. So there's no extra stitching to do here. You're just going to continue working through both sides. So the next set of stitches and both sides. Sometimes you might want to pull both pieces apart and put them on your hook individually in case it's a little difficult to sort of see what you're doing. Remember, take your time. There's no rush. You don't have to work extra stitches. You don't need to do two together or anything. You're just going to continue single crocheting all the way around the top of your toe, and you should have a nice, even, rounded edge going. If you feel that this is pulling or buckling, you can use the same trick I told you about in the heel. So you can work two individual single crochets into the same pair of stitches, and that will give you just a little extra slack in the corner. But if you feel that it's just moving along quite nicely, then you don't have to do anything extra. Just continue to pick up two sets of stitches and single crochet them together. Okay, I'm at the corner that is the heel. Again, just like the toe, nothing special to do here. I'm just going to continue working two sets of stitches together in single crochet. If you feel that it's pulling or it wants to, it's not, you know, loose enough and it's starting to lose its nice rounded shape, you can always work two single crochet into the same corner stitch like this. So that's two single crochet into the same corner stitch, and that will just round your edge out a little more. You can do that, or you can skip it. If your stitching is nice and loose, then you probably don't need it. But if you just want that little extra bit of give in the corner, just work two single crochet through that corner pair of stitches, and then continue. All right, I have finished single crocheting both sides together. I am now up to the top corner on my other side. Here's where things get interesting. You'll notice on my finished stocking that the border across the top is the same width as the border along the sides. There's a neat way to do this without actually having to stop what you're doing and put on a completely different ring. So instead of single crocheting both sides together, you're going to put your fingers between them, identify the next stitch on the front of your stocking, and just single crochet directly into that. And the next one. And each one across the top of just the front part of your Christmas stocking. Okay, I'm completely across the front, and now I'm at the corner where I started single crocheting everything together. I want this to look pretty smooth, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to work that sort of end single crochet into the side of the one I joined my yarn with. So I'm just going to stick my hook right through that stitch. So right through that stitch that I joined, this is where I joined my yarn to create my single crochet row together. And I'm going to single crochet through it. So it's sort of an odd grab. I'm just going right through that stitch. And now I'm going to spin my work so that I'm looking at the back. And I'm going to continue just single crocheting into each stitch, now across only the back side. And you can see that that funny little grab kind of makes the whole border look like it's all part of the same thing. So it gives me a nice little rounded edge, just like it does here, but it all looks like it's part of the same thing. And that joining single crochet just sort of disappears into the overall border. So let's just finish across the back, and then we'll put on our little hanger. All right, I've come across the top back of my stocking. I'm all the way back to that first corner, and just to make it look kind of neat and tidy, I'm going to pick a corner edge stitch, anyone will do, and I'm going to slip stitch into it. So I'm not single crocheting anymore, just slip stitching, almost as though I were finishing the row. Let's say I started it there to go around in a circle. I'm just slip stitching to the top of that, and that will give me a nice even sort of shaped border all the way around the front and the back. And now all we have to do is put on the little hanger. So we're going to chain 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So there's 12. I think that's good enough. I'm going to bring my hook back down to the same stitch where I worked my last slip stitch and slip stitch that right into that corner. Now you can leave it like this. I think that's a pretty decent amount of strength. I don't know how much heavy stuff you might put in your stockings, but this is a pretty decent strength. If you wanted it to be a little thicker, you could single crochet around it too and then slip stitch into the bottom, but I think I like that simple little look. I'm going to just slip stitch into the next stitch just for a little bit of neat and tidiness. Then I'm going to snip my yarn and I'm going to weave in. So there's my yarn snipped. I'm going to fasten off. You don't need much of a tail, but just enough that you can weave it in so that it won't come undone. Grab your yarn needle and weave your tail inside the lip of your new stocking. And there you go. One adorable Christmas stocking, or two.
And there you go, one traditional granny square Christmas stocking. And don't forget, you don't have to stop right here. You can also applique little snowflakes onto it, or stars, or even little sunshines. We've got all sorts of nifty appliques that you can crochet as well in our applique playlist. You can also find description box links for some of them down below. And make sure that you personalize your granny square stockings. So if you've made them all one color like this one, imagine how pretty it would look with a snowflake right in the middle. Especially a neat way to use up any of the extra little bits of yarn you might have left over from your projects. One of these 100 gram balls should make you several of these granny square stockings. So I got 8 squares out of this. I also made some Christmas trees out of this, and I still have a whole bunch left. So don't be surprised if you've got leftovers, but that's good because you can always make more Christmas material. I'm going to go hang this up now downstairs and hope that possibly Santa Claus or maybe La Befana comes and stuffs it full of nice things for me. Maybe some chocolates, maybe a new car, some checks, you know, that kind of thing. Remember, everybody, if you've got comments, you can leave them down below. And I'd also especially like to know if you guys have got these in your family. This is an old craft, much beloved by many generations, and there are many variations on the Granny Square Christmas stocking, and I'd love to hear how yours differ, because these are really, really cool. We will see you again really soon on the Jaded Stitches Show, everyone. Until then, stay safe, stay crafty, and have an excellent week. Bye!